Welcome, everyone. We'd like to welcome you to Teaching Skills-Based Decision-Making through Experiential Learning Across Disciplines. And I'm Rhonda Bondie from the Harvard Graduate School of Education.
I'm Joanna, and I'm from the Cabot Science Library.
I'm Baruch Krauss from the Medical School.
And what brought us together was this HILT project, where we came together because we were trying to teach the art of our disciplines. And so for me, it was in the education, helping teachers make decisions to include all students in the classroom. So how do we do this? And for Baruch, in the medical students in the emergency room, how do doctors build trusting relationships with students? And we realized through HILT, they brought us together as this interdisciplinary team. Joanna and I were working together, thinking through how can we prepare our students for professions where they're making decisions in contextual situations that are dynamic and that are interactive and also time-bound. So we realized by talking together that there is a problem. There's no common framework or methods or principles, assessment tools, leaving faculty to develop the art of decision-making in our discipline on our own. Without assessment tools, it made it difficult to personalize instruction for our students and focus in on specific skills that individual students need to develop. So we embarked on this project together.
So our project is built, Our project is built on a series of faculty interviews where we explore what do you teach, how do you teach it, and look to uncover the underlying framework and common principles, methods, and assessment tools in order to develop a model for best practice.
Yes. So what we started off was trying to find out who to really talk to, since there were a bunch of faculty across the university. This was the hardest part for us, because we sent out a lot of emails and we weren't hearing back. So we started to tap into our own networks, as well as we started looking into the syllabus explorer to figure out who is really teaching decision making in their own disciplines. We then would reach out to the faculty and schedule 1-hour interviews. And it was also a process to find the time for all of us to meet with them and then for their schedules to align with ours. And once we started interviewing them, we had a set of interview questions that really honed in on what are they doing in the classroom? How is it experiential? Are they using common assessment tools as well as kind of a larger methodology? And then we started to record the interviews and then also transcribe it. And then we came up with a coding framework, and now we're currently in the analysis phase. And we've been really, really lucky to be able to interview faculty. Right now we've interviewed around 12 faculty members all across campus, and we are learning so much from them, from like escape rooms through and also like different role plays. So currently we've been doing, can I go to the next slide? Different types of coding categories through the faculty interviews. So we looked at what are the teaching methods, and we, from the interviews, we looked at, okay, are they doing different types of discussion scenarios? Is there some theories that we can extrapolate, common principles, as well as skills, and a list of other things?
So on the left are the activities that are in process. So as Joanna talked about, we've done a faculty search. We're in the middle of doing faculty interviews in the process of transcription and coding, and are beginning the analysis. On the right are the activities that we're planning to do. We're going to do a faculty convening, which is to bring together the faculty that we interviewed to show them a draft of the model that we're developing, to get feedback on that from them, and also for an opportunity. You know, most of the faculty who are doing experiential learning and skills-based decision-making have developed their own approach and their own in their own little silo. And we thought that cross-communication among different disciplines doing the same kind of teaching would be very useful. Then we're going to initiate several research studies, both at the medical school and at the Ed School. We'll synthesize and do model development. We want to thank a number of people. The first is Jamie Goldstein, who is a true connector in the Malcolm Gladwell mode.
And then we also want to thank Josh Bookin, who is at the Ed School, but also our coach. And he did a similar project for more didactic teaching called Instructional Moves. And he shared a lot of his context and gave us kind of like a framework to think about how to approach our project.
And finally, Janaba, who is supporting us with our future studies, where we can take this framework and really collect some data from our students and analyze their learning. So we're really grateful for that.